just start off by saying I'm really sorry, but I have forgotten again to actually rename this ride. So it's not it's obviously not the British Cycling Race. But then if you've joined early enough, which you have, you can see it's the Haute route, Watopia Stage 1. Just kind of kicked it up. Not giving myself much time, but then my sleep is more important. I'm wearing Bynea Cycling socks today. New white ones, pro length, nice and long. Gotta make sure I have them on the right feet. Hey Ruben. I'm not sure today what I'm gonna do, to be honest. Well, we've got some good news. So, being here with Charlie, I've actually lost weight. Not that there's any hard evidence to suggest it, but I am visibly smaller, and so I've taken the liberty of dropping my weight on Zwift from 60 to 59. I know there's no hard evidence, but I'm in tune with my body enough, I think, to know when I'm in pretty thin shape and then thin shape, and that's where I am right now. Definitely, personally, Phil, I see it on the waist. You just get really flat, don't you? Like, you feel flat, not even bloated. And, like, my backside is, there's nothing to it. Basically, my back goes into my hamstrings. There's no glutes. I am doing all the three, but I've no idea yet. Whether or not I'm going to actually be competitive in all of them or just some of them. I'm just using it as an excuse really to just get some hours in on the bike indoors. I had two crumpets with honey for breakfast. So about 40 grams of carbs for breakfast, 50 grams of carbs, and I've got two bottles of beta fuel, so good to go pretty much. Forgive me while I just finish setting up here. Oh, I've only given myself 5 minutes to time my shoes. It's not like me. Easy day. How did you figure that?
Bit weird this one actually, going up the short KLM first. That's a bit strange, isn't it? I don't think I've ever done one that's like an event like this that's gone up that hill first. I don't like it because I think it gives, you know, if you're only just in the A category, it really puts you on the back foot, because like if it goes hell for leather up there after 2K and you dropped, then that's your race over, it. Morning, Mike. Okay, let me just check we've got everything. Drinks, food, bars, fan, brain. Yeah, so we've got everything. Just gonna charge this. If you're new here, this is exactly what I'm like before it is. But my warm-ups don't differ out on the road as well. My warm-ups don't differ out on the road, if you're wondering. I'm just as laid back. Yeah, no worries, Phil. I don't need you to give me a reason. Fair play, Gus. Fair play, Cam. Epic from both of you, to be fair. That's a lot. Okay, so anyway, if you're new here, sorry, if you've just joined, I think you'll notice at the top there, my weight is now 59 kilos. I was just explaining at the start of this video that I'm visibly a lot leaner. Not that you guys will probably notice the difference on the screen, but in Cardiff I've been eating very well, and I've been staying away from biscuits. And I was 60 kilos, so if I'm visibly smaller, then I must be below that. So I've gone, using my own experience, okay, set up, ready to go, I think so. Wow, there's so many people. Oh my word. It's ridiculous.
Allez, allez. Sorry, Phil. I just do what they want, Phil. I'm pretty happy. I'm pretty happy just to sit in, to be honest. Because, no, I'm just training, Luke. Somebody put an idea into my head of attempting a sub 34 minute attempt on the Alp this weekend, so I've got to think how that really fits in with everything else. Hold that wheel, man, hold that wheel. Hold it. You absolute idiot. Nice one. Do you reckon that would work a bit? Because I was thinking that. I was thinking the difference between, like, you know, going off and racing with the front guys at the Alp, and then, you know, getting dragged by those top 10 up the climb, or to start at the back and pick off and use the, I don't know. Hey Tom. Wow, look at this group. This is what we want. Is that Saturday or Sunday, Phil? I don't know why, Tom. I just, it goes back to when I was in college. I had to get up early then to do the, to do my training, but I don't know, I've naturally, I've always enjoyed getting up and training early. Sometimes like I don't have like the legs in the morning. Sometimes I need like a couple of hours to like allow my body to come round. And if you leave it till later in the day as well, sometimes the training session, you have like more time to recover from the previous day's session. Or, you know, yeah, I've had breakfast, 2 crumpets and some honey, got some beta fuel. So the 3-hour race, is that on, yeah. I'm not sure, Phil, like, yeah, tomorrow's the shorter. It's a shorter route. Last chance to invest. I don't know. It depends how I feel tomorrow. This is it, see, you can't rush perfection. I need to get up and ride tomorrow and see how my legs are. And go from there. Or I just have a stab at it anyway, on both days. I suppose there's no harm in going for it tomorrow. And then seeing what I can repeat. Because ironically, I can do my better sessions when I'm tired, so it's not to say I won't be tired from today. It's not quite easy road. It's hard enough just staying in the group. Look at this, it's splitting again. Yeah, preserve energy, you arm. Preserve energy. I might do an effort at
the mountain. But it's like sometimes on most races I can actually get away with sitting in and like not like pushing into zone 3 or zone 4. But with this I can't, because the speed is so high, I can't get away with it. So I was dropped from that group because somebody let the wheel go, but then it's more like even just at 55k an hour holding the wheel. Because what do I want to do with this ride?
Yeah.
Do I want to rub my ego and like come top 10 or top 50? Or do I want to use it as a quality training session and not fist myself? So yeah, but 290 normalised for the first 12 minutes, so it's not easy. I don't know, some of the Canyon boys are in this bus. It'd be quite nice, that big group up in the front. We'll start the split, hopefully. Must have recovered quite quick from last few days. Yesterday was a recovery ride. My heart rate's a little bit elevated. Yeah, we're just sitting on borderline zone 1, zone 2. About 210 watts is borderline, so that's where we're at. Point of reference. It's splitting up, I like. Look at these riders coming back. For some reason, I thought this was the uh, 75k route. Cheers, bud. Here's a Muckle CC rider. I don't know if anyone else has noticed this. But on the last week I've been training indoors. And it's like, it's actually really hard. Because a lot of my rides, even the interval sessions, haven't had big differences between average and normalist. So I'm like, because I'm always pedaling and things, it does give you quite a bit of muscle soreness. You're just constantly riding, sitting in the saddle. Wow, we're losing places. Oh, there's Liam Horan. Hey up, Liam. Nice to see him. Liam was actually our DS in the Tour of Britain, or performance manager, I think we call him nowadays. I think it is easier, isn't it? You mean in sprints or short efforts? Haha, sure, no. On the beers out the back. This is like, there's 3,000 of us. It's almost like, if this was Zwift like 3 months ago, this would be almost a third of like the total highest amount of riders on all in time. Yeah, last few days, yeah, I saw nearly 30k last night. Look at this, it's like a constant stream. Nice though. My ego's not quite like that. I mean, I won't do events just for the sake of doing them. With the big riders. Yeah, Josh, they're every Tuesday and Thursday. Um, this week I'm probably going to have two really hard days. Well, I've had one hard day, and that was Tuesday. So I did a big interval session just prior to doing the British Cycling Zwift Racing series. And here's Chris Goodbard. He's from my local cycling club. So it's more a case of like managing the effort. Look at these people like, oh my god, what's going on? I hope they're watching the stream. Can't think of anything better. Watching the stream on Zwifting at the same event. Well, the problem with that, Tom, is if I do it, I don't just want to do it. Do you know what I mean? I want to actually smash it. That's the problem. Hey, how you doing? Well, that's it. I did attempt to go for it outside once. And I failed. Now, so the plan this weekend is to do my personal fastest time up the Alp, whatever that will be. That could be tomorrow, or it could be Sunday. And I want to, if it is tomorrow, well, it doesn't matter which day it is, I want our hard day on Sunday. So I want to have three hard days this week, three hard sessions, three hard intervals, and then the rest of it is just, well, this basically. Thank you, James. Nice and early, it seems to be a different crowd here. Morning, sir. Well, the real life version of this is an actual race. But kind of gets turned into a bit of a stroll just like this for a lot of people. I'll try, dude. I'm actually liaising with Phil. Phil's probably doing a bit of work in between watching this, so I'm lazy with Phil. Phil really wants me to do it, so Phil's kind of my PR guy. No intervals today. Well, nothing structured. So that doesn't mean I won't do anything. I might want to open my legs up a little bit. Ah, okay, got you, Div. I got you. Totally understandable. So what was the general consensus about me doing this, attempting my fastest time of the Alp? Do I use the people who have gone off ahead? Or like, do I use, so like, they go off and then I try to like use the draft to pick them off, or does that bring danger of me getting stuck behind people? Or do I just stick with the fast ones and then ride at their pace, you know, which is whatever it is, 5.5 watts per kilo. Just like you would in the tour, and then all in the last like 3 or 4 K. I love riding zone ones though too. So underrated. Well, that's what I'm thinking of is getting stuck. Not so much a draft. I don't know. Guess what you're saying? The Millensteins, can I even get those? Or do I need to be like level 30? Well, the Canyon ZCC guys hit me up. And they're like, if you want to do it, we can support it. But I want to have 2 stabs in it, really. I want to do my own thing and see what I can do. And then we'll go from there. I think. Yeah, that's what I'm thinking, Dave. Like, mentally, it would make it tough, wouldn't it? Also, it makes it quite nice to be able to catch people, but say if I don't end up catching the top 5, and that starts to fry in my brain. Yeah, we might be doing like 21k an hour up there, so what is 21k an hour draft effect? Target watt per kilo. For the majority, 5.5 to 5.7-ish. And then all in, so a big negative split. Basically exactly how I ride time trials. Yeah, but this is the thing we need to talk about. Like, do I do the tour fire and ice? So do I start at the sea level, that starting pen, or do I start at the top of that cave, like before you go into the jungle? Because there's 2 different events I can do. There's the short one and the long one. So obviously the long one includes like a 5 minute effort that's really hard at that climb before you get to the app. I need all the help I can get. There's gonna be some pain faces on that one, that's for sure. If I ever got like, I'm probably gonna make up for all of the comments I've had over the years, over the months, of, oh, your racing's boring, there's no red in your graph at all. In fact, there probably won't be tomorrow, or Sunday, or the yellow red. Ah, Tom. You have to put that idea into my head. It's either tomorrow or Sunday on. I'm still not decided. I will put, I'll post it on social media. No. There's a 3-hour event all slow. It's a separate event, it's not the whole route, it's not this series. What I'm gonna do is I'm gonna post it everywhere on social media, and then I'm gonna put, I'm gonna make sure I set a reminder on my YouTube channel. So if you guys click the notification bell, wherever it is, if you haven't already, that's brilliant, but you'll be notified when that will be happening, which is important. Thank you, Mike, and thank you, David. I appreciate it. I suppose you've got to make it entertaining even if you don't win. Because we might be doing a couple of the main Zwift races and some of the, you know, the main Zwift teams over the next couple of weeks. So hopefully we'll be back in the mix of things and providing good entertainment. Ah, cheers, bud. Appreciate it. Because I was looking at that BC event on Tuesday. It was actually really hard for me. Because it was flat and fast. But I was glad that I could be there for that finish and just do something a little bit different. Rather than just waiting for a sprint. That's what you gotta do, innit? Oh dear, it was a special day. It was a very special day. But I'm thankful for everybody who played a part in it. And for the little film crew I had on the day as well. Which allowed us to capture it and have some memories. I think people are starting to flag, actually. I don't think I uploaded it instantly, did I? I think I waited for a bit. So we have a little effort up the radio tower. Well, the BC race was really tough. Normalised power was 370. Which is just over threshold, or just on threshold, kind of. So it was hard. Thank you, Deb. Thank you so much. Cool. It was getting made by a band of climbers. There's no real need for it yet. Basically. So I'm just waiting for the right time. It was getting made ironically in a COVID-19 infected country. So that kind of delayed production a little bit. Which again I'm not bothered about. I don't need it yet anyway. There's that's awesome, man. 362 is 60 kilos. So you're just below me. Awesome. Keep doing what you do. I'm looking forward to when Pritch catches me. Ha ha. little bit more of a sprint. I really like this one actually. No, I'll tell you what, I really like the volcano. I really like the volcano. Lots of different gradients, and like there's a hard finish. I like that. And it's 5 minutes as well. So it's like, it's neither here nor there in terms of, like, you don't really pace it, you just go as hard as you can go. Who on earth is called COVID-19? Look at that. Boneless climb. You have a laugh. Nice one. So in position 385 at the bottom of the boneless climb. Yes, I hate it. Okay, pick a number. What place am I going to be at the top? Boom. Fifty. Big gap. Perfect. With a fellow Welshman. Getting the draft. Getting the draft. Ah, you piece of... just... It's just yellow. That's a 270 normalised now for the first 45 minutes, so that's borderline. Zone 2, zone 3 for those of you that are wondering. My upper zone 2 is like 275. Which is also like 4.6 watts per kilo. Do you know what? That effort felt really smooth. Wonder if I can do the app tomorrow. Jump in with these lads. Or ladies. My goal, by the way, is not to make anybody look bad, just for the record. That's kind of like the colours we're looking for tomorrow or Sunday. That kind of yellow, little bit of red. If anything, those reds would be perfect on like the steeper sections. You might see a little bit of like green or yellow, I think, from like hairpins. Thank you, Phil. Well, another little group. So what was I before we started that bit of the climb? It's like 280, right? $385? No way. Yeah, that's what a level slow. You're exactly right. Yeah. What about it, Josh? They'd be grim, wouldn't they? Yeah. Very true, Johan. Well, we might crack the top 200 here, ladies and gentlemen. Where are we going now? Right. I'm actually glad I put in that spurt now, because this is always like a long, long downhill. Yeah, it was four. Well, it was 4.2. Well, it was 4.35 for like 11 and a bit. So yeah, you're probably right. About 4.25 for 14. It was probably borderline. If you follow the power duration curve, it was borderline 400 for 20 minutes, so my FTP would have been around 380. But of course, you know, I hadn't done like an hour time trial, so there's no real way of, that's just an estimate, isn't it? An FTP at the end of the day is just an estimate. Whether or not I could actually sustain 380 is another thing, because that's like a hill climb weight, or even not a hill climb weight, that still would have been 6.2 watts per kilo-ish for an hour, wouldn't it? Or more, possibly. So, but the thing is, like, I was very specific, I got very specific, so by training for that 12-minute effort, you know, it had the effect of lifting my 20-minute power and my FTP, in theory. Right now my FTP is kind of sitting at like 365, 375, somewhere in that region. So I'm not far, well, I'm pretty much the same weight. I think I will. I think there'll be some races where I can wear it. And if not, I'll still go and wear it. If I do, like, you know how Phil Guymon wears his skin suit to do like Strava segments? I definitely do that. You know, make the most of it. Like, wear it when you can. Gives you added motivation as well, like, you know, you've earned it and it feels nice to wear it. If it makes it go harder because you're wearing it, then so be it, like. We've got the volcano now, yeah. Looks like it. Went to an effort up there. Okay. One more waving up there. Sorry, Josh. It's because the chat's up there. I'll see you soon. Anyone else losing time on GC to go up the stage wins? That's brilliant. I counted myself in that. I don't think it's done on where's those UCs, huh? Look at that. Horse breathing. Lovely. I love that. It's like, it's such a signature thing, isn't it? It's great, like, when somebody has something like that that everybody can relate to. Ooh, that's interesting, Josh. Thanks for that. Gotcha. Oh, I'm in the top 200. Okay, until the climb, I think. Something like that. hold the wheel for goodness sake. There's no one behind you, fair enough. But if I'm sat there behind you, don't lose the wheels. Just sprint. A surge. People in front of us in groups anymore. It's a bit sad. Oh, there's a group. Yeah, it is a fantastic effort, Paul. Thank you, Linda. I want to make it look easy, but it's not. It's nice, this though. It's opening me out really nice. Heart rate's gradually rising. Not too much load. Good cadence. We'll go again now when we get back onto the flats and then carry it to the finish. Just giving myself enough recovery and using the terrain to do that really. That's 273 normalised power in just over an hour. Again, still borderline zone 1, zone 2. Intensity factor of 0.75, which is like right in that kind of endurance range, they call it. Average power 243. So just, yeah, like exactly 4 watts per kilo, or just slightly over. Oh, that was a flat road then. I wish they'd do it more, to be honest, Linda. I wish there was more of it on TV or YouTube or anywhere really. The type of person I am. And I love seeing it and hearing it, so I will share it. Oh, Kid Bog is behind me now. Sorry, Chris. Top tip how to ride this course. Okay, the first climb is going to be hard, you know that, so log in early, get near the front, give yourself as much sliding room as possible. Don't do what I did. Just treat it really hard. Treat it really hard. Even if you sacrifice a little bit of your warm up so that you're a little bit fresher for that first hill, then you can hit it with a bit more fresh, right, shall we say. Once you get over it, find a little group, stay with that group until you hit the KOM, then ride it. It's going to take you 20 minutes, 25 minutes, ride it at whatever intensity you know you can sustain. For that amount of time. If people are riding away from you, don't worry about it. Just ride your own pace, and then when you come into, hey, there's Chris. When you come into like this area, you just got to give it everything. The volcano's unforgiving, you know that, don't you? So, you know, you're probably more likely to, if you want a better finishing position, easiest thing to do is to ride as hard as you can on the climbs within your capacity and sit in on a group or find a group everywhere else, because you're 100%, you saw it there. You know, I make up so many numbers, and you can too, on the climbs. No worries, Paul. It's a good little group, working hard. Can you hear the trainer at all? Apart from me changing gear, obviously. I gave it a clean yesterday. I cleaned the chain, did everything, and I can hardly hear anything, so I'm assuming you can't. It really does amaze me, actually, just how quiet these smart trainers can be. Very cheery on. It's getting strung out. Yeah, to be fair, the fan is just there, and the microphone is just there, so there's not much difference. I've seen people use power pedals they're pretty okay, I've heard. Sorry, said me. That's the beauty of that's the beauty of live streams, though. Well. The go to the top. Big numbers, yeah. 5.5 watts per kilo. 6 watts per kilo. Jeffrey Bouchard. If that is the Jeffrey Bouchard, I have no idea. Ollie Jones, Hans West. They got pretty low. Their power is pretty accurate. That's pretty low. That's pretty average, but it's what I'd expect for that type of duration. Now we get into the top 10. There's the guy who's in 8th place is a proper weapon, I've heard. A proper weapon. So let's find out who's in the top. Oh, Zacharin. Zacharin's in 6th. Because if you notice these pros, they've got such high power to weight. They're not winning the event. I say that, but now we're about to go to number 1. Let me get up there. Okay, so the guy who came first is obviously not legit. The guy who came second and third, obviously not legit. I saw that in the chat. The guy who came fourth, that's not legit. 7 watts per kilo for 65 minutes is impossible. So Massa. Massa won from Zacharin. By the looks of it, 5 watts per kilo is accurate. Zacharin puts out 0.4, but maybe half a watt kilo more, and doesn't win. Does come down to a sprint though. Zacharin actually cleans up these top few places in a sprint, which is a bit rare. You wouldn't expect Zacharin to. What do you think of that analysis? That's better than Calvin Kirby any day, innit? Thank you, Dave. Thank you, everybody, for watching. Hope you enjoyed chatting, if nothing else. I'm going to give some of these guys some love. And let's give Zacharin some love. Who else should we? What else we got? Give these dudes some love. Yeah. So what was that front group then? That front group was 10 minutes, not 11 minutes 44. And then it was a really small group actually. It was only like 6 in a minute. Must have been fairly hard, look. Alex West and Ollie Jones. Average heart rate 164. I mean, that's fairly, like, substantially high for those guys. I know what they're capable of doing. So where were we? We were 141st. What was my average? My average is 133 beats per minute. 4.1 watts per kilo. So we only finished like 8 minutes, 7 minutes behind. 8 minutes behind. I'll take that. I'll take that. Kirchmer, I think is how you say it, is he has one of the fastest times up out of the Zwift, and so does and the forward KRM, I think. No, not the forward KRM, the epic KRM. I think he's got quite a good time up there as well.
Okay.
Well, you know what, guys? Thank you so much for watching.
I have wet in my name because we ride for the Wahoo Esports team, WET. And that's its unfortunate abbreviation.
So, it doesn't fit any other way, see? If we just add Wahoo, it doesn't fit, it cuts it off. So, well, that explains it.
Alright, thank you so much for watching. I'm going to put a jersey on and carry on riding now that it's not going to be as intense. So, thank you so much for watching as usual. See you tomorrow and the day after. Pop, 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 pop